Nicole Reyhle, coming to you from ASD Market Week. And joining me today is the founder of Seller Active, Jason Harra. Welcome.
Thanks, Nicole. Great to be here.
Jason, I'm constantly looking at numbers and seeing what's happening in the e-commerce space, and the growth continues to just spike. Mm-hmm. What can you speak to in regards to that?
Yeah, so in 2017, fourth quarter year-over-year growth was 17%. And really, it stood out to me as an incredibly big number, given that e-commerce has been around for quite a while. It's actually the largest jump year over year since 2011. Amazon.com was 70% of that growth. So the marketplaces and the big marketplaces like Amazon, eBay, Walmart, you know, Jet are a large chunk of U.S. e-commerce growth and are not slowing down.
So for marketplace selling specifically, can you explain how that works in regards to sellers online? Should they be in all the spots? Some of the spots, what's the strategy you suggest?
Great question. So a lot of folks who are just getting started think they should be everywhere, that being on every channel will maximize the ROI. And we would advise them to actually look at the big three marketplaces, Amazon, eBay, and Walmart first, and make sure that their listings are optimized before they expand to other channels, because each one of those channels comes with some labor cost for cancellations, returns, accounting, taxes. So we definitely advise folks to start with the big ones, who are really 80% plus of the market anyway, before they expand to the smaller niche marketplaces.
So you said a buzzword there, which was optimize.
Yep.
So can you explain what that really means for someone who might just be starting out in e-commerce?
Sure. There's listing optimization, so that'd be high quality images, high quality content. There's price optimization, so that would be using a repricer like ours to maximize your margins by taking into account all the variables associated with the buy box. And then there would be efficiencies and optimizations for your back end operations for order management, inventory management.
Fantastic. Sounds like there's a lot to think about.
Yeah.
When it comes to learning more about this, what resources do you suggest for online sellers to lean on?
Well, I would check out ASD, and I also check out Amazon has a new seller program, a blog. eBay's got a great set of resources for new sellers. It's always got fresh content. If you call these guys, they will give you personal recommendations. They'll introduce you to category managers, which is invaluable. I mean, really, that's the best resource you can get at a marketplace as a category manager. Or call Seller Active, will give you free advice.
That's great to know as well. Yeah. Now, when we look at selling at large, if you could offer one tip to really help someone increase their success of online sales, what would that tip be?
I would say if they're not using the marketing resources of these marketplaces, so sponsored ads, to check out sponsored ads, very low competition, very high ROI, and if they're not using a repricer, to check out a repricing technology. Those are the two major things that you can bring into bear.
Great insight. So when it comes to product selling, I'm always curious, how is it that sellers define what they should sell versus potentially what they could be selling?
Yeah, so I would recommend using the publicly available data that's on the marketplace channels themselves, sales rank by product, sales rank by category. Do your research on the competition in those categories, where they source their products, you know, where you source your products, and just basically analyze you know, what you think you can do on another channel based on Amazon sales rank.
All right, so Jason, are there any pitfalls that online sellers should avoid?
There's quite a few. When you're first getting started and you're reaching multiple channels, make sure you have a tool that will sync your quantities. So you cannot afford to have a bad feedback associated with a canceled item that you couldn't fulfill. So you'll need to make sure your quantities are in sync across all your channels.
Fantastic, that's great advice. Is there any advice you can offer online sellers to help them excel in their efforts?
Yeah, I would say they should leverage the free tools available on each marketplace. So Amazon has marketing tools, Amazon has logistic tools, Amazon has customer service tools that are available for free just for being a seller. Likewise with eBay and Walmart, it's a lot more efficient than hiring your own staff, learning how to do this process from scratch. That's the first, I think, advice I'd give. Second would be logistics. So if you don't have products in FBA yet, I would send some products there. It's way less expensive than starting your own warehouse and your own fulfillment system. And at a certain point, you may decide to branch out and do your own fulfillment. But to start with, leveraging their logistics is probably the best advice I can give.
That's a great tip right there. Jason, that was fantastic. Thank you so much. Join us again as we share more expert insight direct from the floors of ASD Market Week.